So once again, I welcome on the class of construction management. So today I will discuss about the critical path method. And in critical path method, I will discuss the different types of event time, and after that various types of activity time. And after that, I will discuss the float. And there are four types of float. The first one is total float, and after that free float, and independent float, and interfering float. And on the basis of this float, we can discuss the decide whether our path is critical path, subcritical path, or supercritical path. So let us discuss about the critical path method. So in the previous discussion, we have already differentiated between the PERT and CPM. So critical path method is a deterministic approach, and only one time estimates made for each activity. And this is the activity oriented network, and only one time estimates is required. And this each activity follow normal probability distribution. So there are two types of event time. So firstly, I will discuss about the event time. So event time is, the first one is earliest event time. So what is earliest event time? So it is the earliest time in which an event may occur in the project. So earliest event time, if I discuss, so earliest event time, let us assume this is our network. So it will be I dash, I double dash, and this is J, event J. The time to complete this activity is Tij, Ti dash J, and Ti double dash J. And the earliest starting time Tei, earliest starting time Tei dash, and Dei double dash. And here it is Tej. So we can write Tej is equal to Tei plus Tij, Tei dash plus Ti dash J, or Tei double dash plus Ti double dash J. Maximum value will be the earliest event time. Similarly, the latest allowable occurrence time. So latest allowable time, it is the latest time in which an event may allow to occur without affecting the schedule completion time of the project. So let us assume this is this is I, this is J, J dash, and J double dash. Similarly, Tij, Ti, J dash, and Ti, J double dash. And this is TLJ, TLJ dash, and TLJ double dash. And this is TE, TLI. So TLI can be written as TLI is equal to TLJ minus TIJ, or TLJ dash minus Tij dash, or TLJ double dash minus Tij double dash. And minimum value will be the latest allowable occurrence time. So this is the minimum value we have to take. So we have discussed about the earliest event time and latest allowable occurrence time. Similarly, the activity times or activity time is classified into four types: early starting time, early finish time, latest starting time, and latest finish time. So what is early start time? So it is the earliest time in which an activity can be started in a particular project. An activity starts when its tail event occurs. Hence, if the tail event of an activity occurs at its earliest time, it also starts at its earliest time. So let us assume this is our event I and this is event J. And the event I has early starting time is TEI. And latest starting time is TLI. Similarly, early finish time is the TEJ and latest finish time is TLJ. So early starting time can be written as this is the TEI is the early starting time. So this is the early starting time. Similarly, early finish time. So early finish time can be written as TEJ is the early finish time. So it can be written as TEJ, TEI plus TIJ. So it is the earliest time in which an activity can finish in a particular project. If an activity starts at its earliest time, then it also finished earliest time. So we can write here early finish time is equal to early starting time. Here we can see that early finish time is equal to early starting time plus time to complete the activity. So here we have written early finish time is equal to early starting time plus TIJ, or TEJ is equal to TEI plus TIJ. Similarly, latest finish time. So it is the latest time in which if an activity finish, there is a no effect over the schedule completion time of the project. So latest finish time is denoted by TLJ. So latest finish time is TLJ. Similarly, latest start time can be computed as latest finish time minus TIJ. So it is the latest time in which an activity can be started without affecting the schedule completion time of the project, and latest starting time can be written as latest finish time minus TIJ. So here latest starting time is equal to latest finish time minus TIJ, we can write. Now I am going to discuss about the float. So there are float in CPM is analogous to slack. Whatever the use of slack in what we have studied, the same use of the float in the CPM. Like in the but we have seen that if for any event, if the value of slack is zero, so that event is called critical event. Similarly, in CPM analysis, if any event has a float value is zero, then we have the that event is called critical event. Otherwise, and if it is positive, then subcritical, and if it is negative, then supercritical event. So there are four types of float. The first one is the total float, second one is free float, independent float, and interfering float. So let us discuss one by one what is total float. So total float, it is the time, it is the time by which starting or finishing of an activity can be delayed without affecting the schedule completion time of the project. It may also be defined as excess of maximum time available over the activity duration. So if I write the, let us assume this is our event I and this is our event J, and event I has early starting time TEI and latest starting time is TLI. Similarly, event J has early finish time is TEJ and latest finish time is TLJ, and time to complete this activity is TIJ. So we can write total float. Total float can be written as here. Total float is equal to total float will be TLJ TEI plus TLJ minus TEI plus TIJ will be the total float. So it will be TLJ minus TEI plus TIJ. J will be the total float. So this total float can also be written as total float is equal to TLJ. So TLJ is, what is this TLJ? TLJ is the latest finish time minus TEI plus TIJ is the early finish time. So it can also be written as latest finish time minus early finish time. TLJ is the latest finish time and TEI plus TIJ is the that is TEJ. So TEJ is the early finish time. Similarly, the total float can also be written as TLJ minus TIJ minus TEI. So we can write TLJ minus TIJ. So TLJ minus TIJ is the latest start time minus TIEI is the early start time. So it can also be written as total float is equal to latest start time minus early start time. So free float, excess of time available over the activity duration. And the concept of free float, on the basis of fact that all the event must occur at their earliest time. So the free float, the expression of free float can be computed like that. This is event I and this is event J. This is early starting time, latest starting time, early finish time and latest finish time, and the time TIJ is the time to complete this activity. So free float can be written as free float is equal to TEJ minus TEI plus TI. J is the expression of total float. Free float. And total float can be written as total float is TLJ minus TEI plus TIJ. So TEI plus TIJ, TEI plus TIJ can be written as TLJ minus total float. So free float can be written as free float is equal to TEJ minus TEI plus TIJ can be written as minus TLJ minus minus plus total float. So it can also be written as total float minus TLJ minus TEJ. And TLJ minus TEJ is the slack of event J. So total float can also be written as free float. Free float can also be written as total float minus slack of J. So this is also written as free float is equal to total float minus S J is the slack of event J, that is slack is latest allowable time minus early expected time. So this is the free float can also be written as total float minus slack of J. By writing proper way, so it will be free float. Similarly, the third one is independent float. So excess of minimum time available over the activity duration. While analyzing the independent float of an activity, neither a preceding activity nor the starting of the succeeding activity is affected. So let us discuss what is the expression of independent float. So this is I, this is J event, and this is TEI, TLI, this is TEJ, and this is TLJ, this is TIJ. So the expression of independent float can be written as FID is equal to TEJ minus TLI plus TIJ. So independent float is equal to early finish time of event J minus latest starting time of event I plus dij. This independent float can also be written in terms of free float. So free float minus slack of event I. It can also be written as. Similarly, independent float can also be written as in terms of total float. So total float minus slack of event I minus slack of event j, where Si is the slack of event I and Sj is the slack of event j. Means Si is equal to TLi minus TEi, Sj is equal to TLj minus TEj. So this is the independent expression of independent flow. Last float is interfering float. So interfering float is the just another name given to the head event slack j. And interfering float can be written as Sj, or the expression of interfering float can also be written as interfering float is difference between total float minus free float. That is the expression of interfering float. So when as I told you that the float in CPM is analogous to the slack in PERT. So on the basis of this total float value, we will decide whether our path is critical, subcritical or supercritical. So if an event has total float value is positive, then that event is called subcritical event and path connected by such event is called subcritical path. So for subcritical path, total float value should be positive. Similarly, if an event has total float value is 0, then that event is called critical event and path connected by such event is called critical path. And for such path, total float value should be 0. Similarly, if an event has total float value is negative, then that event is called super critical event and path connected by such event is called super critical path. So on the basis of total float, we will decide whether our event is critical, subcritical or supercritical. So if the total float value for any event is positive, then that event is called subcritical event. If the total float value for any event is 0, then that event is called a critical event. And if the total float value for any event is negative, then that event is called supercritical event.